Next year when I have my desk, I'll tell you guys, I'll show you guys when I have my desk. No clue how the finance is gonna happen though, or where I'm gonna stay even, but it's gonna happen. I just finished working today and I was just saying to myself, this is my dream desk. You know, there's like a beautiful screen. It needs a trackpad, but check this out. And now it's just right there, like a standing desk. And when you sit, you can put exactly how high, tall you want, so that it doesn't, you don't hunch your back. And when you stand, it's what? I'm going on this faith thing and saying a year from now, I'm gonna have an awesome desk with an awesome screen and awesome wireless stuff. When I come home to work, it's gonna be there. I've spent the last couple of months trying to build my own work desk and it's now here in metal and wood. Now the question of the hour, of course, is do you need a standing table? For me, I think the answer is gonna be a yes. That's a personal answer. That's the new postcard. Thanks, Erica. This is what I'm looking at when I'm working. But if you zoom out to see the full picture, there's actually a lot of convenience going on. First of all, I have these three different buttons over here. Pressing these buttons already remembers my exact standing height, my exact sitting height, and the exact height when my chair goes in. Apart from the health benefits, there was also this famous writer that wrote with a standing desk. He didn't have a mechanical kind of one, but then he just liked to stand and write with his pen or his typewriter. I don't work with standing up on my videos. I'd like to sit down on a comfy chair. But I spend a lot of time working on my Urdu. So when I'm doing my Urdu thing, I open up my Urdu book. I have my awesome screen that's showing me the Urdu text to write. And then I'm standing and writing. And I think this part I really enjoy. My thighs would go up when I keep my feet on the floor, neatly planted. And I always had this posture when I was editing. And now, I don't. When I'm working late into the night, I can just slide in my super comfortable chair and go all the way behind. That way, my back is doing none of the work and I'm just editing. When it comes to having a serious place where I get my work done, for me, that's a big pro. Helps me get productive and it helps me get into the zone. There is, of course, the screen. The price was so low for Black Friday that I just went ahead and I bought it. I like the size of it because when you're editing, it gives you kind of a wholesome kind of a feel relative to the 24, which is much smaller. 32 is just too big. Also, I watch a lot of movies on my computer, so I can connect this and just chill on my bed. Now this stand is mounted in a small tiny corner on my desk. That's awesome because the display itself is not taking any real estate on my desk, and that way it clears up the space. Secondly, the stand also has really great angles and it lets me have multiple kind of configurations depending on the need. When I'm shooting, I like my camera to be where my screen is, and if I want to move to a specific angle, I can just hold the screen and move it and it holds it right there. Two more things that I added onto this desk to make it my dream desk or my awesome desk. One is the fact that I'm gonna move it a lot. That means all the cable needs to be very well arranged, and secondly, I need to do it without troubling the people who live downstairs. Because this is a heavy desk, 15 kilos just for the metal on this desk. When it comes to the wires, everything was just dangling down below behind, and I was fine with that because it didn't really bother me. Sometimes it got in my way with my feet and with my chair going in and coming out. Now this tray holds all my stuff inside. It does what it's supposed to do. It gets all the wires out of the way, and there's just one wire going to the wall. These wheels are such an excellent addition to the desk because first of all, I can lock these guys so that they don't move when I don't want them to. And when I want them to move, I can just pull them and move them almost all around the important places in my room. For example, now I'm shooting with the sunlight coming out of the window. So I needed the desk to hold my camera, which has to be close to the window. For someone who's never invested in chairs before, I think it's on the expensive side. But then chairs go up all the way to $1,000 and plus, 80,000 rupees that is. And this guy is not that expensive relative to those big boys. But he is so comfortable for the price. It invites me to work on a Saturday morning. So sometimes when I'm working from home, I bring my work computer. All I need to do is pull the desk and connect the work computer from behind. And now I have a place to keep my work computer. Moving houses is going to be a hassle, but every Saturday morning is a bliss to work. And on the con side, I think, first of all, the price. If you don't have the cash, that's a huge con. Secondly, I think an entry-level desk can get really wobbly. So you better want to steer clear of that. If that bothers you, then either get a rigid desk or get a high-end sit-stand desk. That's another con. In my time of using this last couple months, of course it's convenient. There's no two ways about it. But I don't want to call it a productivity desk. I wanted to call it a comfortable desk. I was pretty productive even when I was uncomfortable. We're living in strange times and it's not just a regular rhythm day or regular rhythm week. So I'm not as productive as before. But the desk really doesn't add or remove anything onto that productivity. You know, it just definitely makes me very comfortable. It has not made me more productive. I just thought that you guys should know. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'll see you guys around. Keep learning.